This time, we spend some time in the heart of the Dolomites in northern Italy. We walk around Cortina d'Ampezzo and take the long cable car up to Mount Floria. Stick around. Magnificent scenery to come. We drove about 5.5 hours, or about 270 kilometres from Bardolino to Cortina in the heart of the Dolomites. We checked into our hotel, which was just on the outskirts of the main town, and it immediately started to rain. That was the only rain that we had for the whole 4 days that we were there, incidentally. And it was really nice. You could see the rain, and it was sunny, and it was a sun shower, and it was really magical just listening to the rain and just looking at it. It looks fantastic. The whole area, the Dolomites and Cortina, utterly fantastic. Cortina's in the Veneto region, and it sits at about 1,224 meters above sea level. That's about 4,000 feet for those that use imperial measures. We escaped some of the heat, but the temperatures in Cortina were around the mid-20s and into the low 30s, which is very, very unusual for Cortina. When we checked into our hotel, the hotel room was quite warm, and I couldn't get the air conditioning to work. And I called reception and said, I think our air conditioning is broken. And the man at reception said, well, that's because, sir, we don't have air conditioning. And I said, what do you mean you don't have air conditioning? It's a four-star hotel. And he said, well, this is probably the hottest it's been for 50 years. Just open a window when it cools down, and it will cool down. And he was right. We did open windows, and it got to the sort of the high teens overnight, just enough to cool the place down. Cortina was the site of the 1956 Olympic Games, the Winter Olympics, and Melbourne, my hometown, was also the site of the 1956 Summer Games. So that's a strange coincidence. Very strange coincidence indeed. Cortina d'Ampezzo is a truly spectacular place. It's in a valley surrounded by towering mountains. The town is very picturesque, fantastic just to walk through the streets and the squares. And it's a very good place to be located because it's close to all the major attractions. We stayed at the edge of the town, and also like a couple minute walk into the town itself. And a short walk to the cable car up to Mount Floria. Cortina's a great town. I was particularly impressed by the main street called Corso Italia. It's basically a high street with full of shops and cafes and restaurants and ice creameries. Points of note are the co-op, where you can buy clothes, souvenirs. There's a supermarket there, so you can buy food and snacks and drinks. There's plenty of camping and hiking shops, and I bought a couple of items of clothes. Really nice stuff there. As I said, cafes and restaurants, plenty of places to enjoy a nice cool beer. There's the basilica and the bell tower that you can just see before. And most of all, just it's in a valley, and there's spectacular views of all the high mountains and Dolomite ranges surrounding the town. It's a truly magical place to spend a few days. I can't recommend it enough. Tanti equipaggi alla posta delle So this is the edge of the main town. And that is our hotel, I believe. No, it's not. That's the name of the hotel that we stayed at Bardolino, the Bellevue. There you go. Our hotel is at the opposite end of town. Truly spectacular backdrop. Day two of our stay at Cortina, we decided to go up to Mount Floria. We had a short walk, 10 minutes or so, from our hotel to the cable car station in Cortina. The cable car is about 2.6 kilometers long and there's a stop in the middle. Mount Floria is 2,123 meters
in Cortina, the
height,
and we're about to go up
7,000 feet above sea level. So,
well, the cable car,
not the biggest mountain I've ever seen, but truly spectacular.
All the way up there, which seems a long way. It's quite a pleasant day, not too hot. It should be about 12 degrees up on the up on the mountain there. So let's find our way to the entrance. Noisy motorbikes. Some of the town of Cortina. So that is the cable car that comes in here. And those two sort of shiny dots on the cables in the distance on the cable cars. My goodness, that looks like a long way. Anyway, we'll see how we go. And here comes the cable car coming down the wires. Alright, I better go inside and catch it.
It costs around €25 per person for a return trip up and down the mountain via the cable car. It was a truly amazing cable car view of all the hills and mountains in the Dolomites, and it got really, really scary towards the top. It was quite steep. For those of you that are scared of heights, best to shut your eyes, I guess. But it offered fantastic views of the surrounding areas and got a very good view of Cortina from the top, the top station. Cable car runs every 15 minutes and it's truly spectacular, well worth both the cost and your time to go up there. And it's just a very short walk from the centre of Cortina d'Ampezzo itself.
Guarda che in alto, andiamo a fare, perdi tutto il panorama, sicuramente. Thank you.
Top that was truly insane, so steep. That's the town of Cortina down below. Thank you. to walk down. Might be time for an espresso, I think. Looks like an inviting cafe.
Lunch and a cup of coffee in the refugio or refuge right near the top of the cable car station, and then decided to get the cable car down back to Cortina. All in all, we probably spent a couple of hours up on the top of the hill admiring the scenery, nature, the sights. Very, very nice, spectacular. Again, I don't think the video or some of the photos I took did justice to the place. Highly, highly recommend it. One of the things that really impressed me was the changing nature and atmosphere in and around Cortina, with different weather, cloudy, a little bit of rain. It was just spectacular just to wake up in the morning and just see the different vistas and how the light would change your view of all the mountain ranges. Just really amazing. We were really enjoying our stay in Cortina. Fantastic location, fantastic scenery. We went to a couple of really nice restaurants, fantastic Italian food. Can't really speak highly enough of it. There'll be more videos to come in the following weeks. And I do hope you've liked this video. If so, please do hit the like and subscribe buttons. And until next time, stay safe. Bye.